anticipatory clapping. You don't know whether it's good or not. Let's hope for this. Alright, how many people were here for the last, so this is part 2 of it. Last time I was focusing on machine learning, this time I will be focusing on MongoDB and Node.js, mostly because I failed terribly at machine learning. So what I did was, I joined Coursera course for machine learning. I powered through for 3 weeks. After that I discovered that it's just too technical, there is very little practical things for me, so I got out. I thought it was always my thing, but after listening to Bharat's last presentation, I understood it because I'm experimentational style learning and I'm very comfortable with theoretical things and I can't be practical elements in it. Alright, so what did I do? I went to my old style of learning, which is make something. So basically I've discovered if I want to learn something, just start doing, creating something in it, I'll just pick up things on the way. So machine learning is slightly difficult to do that, so I started on the other two, MongoDB and Node.js. So before that, MongoDB is a different type of database system. Most of the database systems we use, before I go into this, this will be technical, so if you don't understand any word slash concept, ask me then itself, because literally I am speaking in a different language. So MongoDB is a different type of database. We call it NoSQL. The other type of database is relational database, or RDBMS, relational database management system, which is almost all the databases we use in MAD are relational DBs. For example, MySQL, that's what we use in MAD. The difference is MySQL relational systems are more like a Excel spreadsheet kind of thing. You have multiple rows and you can connect between multiple spreadsheets and sheets and things like that, based on some element in the that row. Node.js, on the other hand, or NoSQL systems, you can have all the different things in the same row itself. Even if it's different type of data, it will have sub rows in it, things like that. It's a very oversimplification of this thing, but that is generally what it is. And Node.js is basically a framework that uses JavaScript to do server-side coding. JavaScript is something that we usually use only in client-side, but lately, because it's a really good language, there is a moment to make it work in server-side also. So, using those two things, I created something called ActiveX, which I don't expect any of you to get the joke, but it was a horrible thing in JavaScript a long time ago, which thankfully we gave up. Alright, so MongoDB versus relational database. So relational databases are good for situations where there are a lot of reads but a few writes. On the other side, NoSQL and MongoDB is good if there is a lot of writes and a few reads. Okay, tell me one example of each. Okay.
Which is the first one?
Lot of reads, few writes.
Logging, Fitbit, for example.
Fitbit
is recording.
Lot of reads.
Okay. Fitbit is an example of the other thing.
Okay.
Lot of reads. Lot of reads, let's say.
Any logging system. Or just any website these days. Most of it is backed by a database. There are anybody who reaches a website, they are reading from the database, but very few instances where they are writing to the database, because that's an administrator. Any kind of logging system is an example of the other thing, because there is a lot of writing going on. So ActiveX is basically a tool which records all the windows that are opened in my computer every 5 minutes. I set the interval as every 5 minutes. It will get a list of all the apps opened and it will mark the active app. So every 5 minutes there is writing, but very few reads, only when I go through this. This is a screenshot of that. Alright, so this is yesterday. Yesterday I was working on it because the presentation was done, very little presentation to do. Anyway, I'm at the office, I make some changes to it. So at 11:05 PM, the Firefox was opened and this was the title of the app. Yeah. These are the next steps. Basically, right now it captures the data, it displays the data. Next, I want to create machine learning capability into that. For that, what I'll do is, perfect. So these are all related. These are all when I'm coding this ActiveX thing. So I can mark everything together and tag it with coding things like that. After I tag enough number of sets, I can actually create a machine learning algorithm which will see how I tagged it and then automatically figure out the correct tag for other undocumented activities. So machine learning, there is three things. Classification, okay, there is one, supervised learning and unsupervised learning. Supervised learning is where I already told them the correct answers. Based on that, they figure out the correct answers for the other sets. So one is called classification, where I classify multiple things into one bucket. Then based on that classification, multiple parameters in that classification, I can do it for other things also. Clustering is a non-supervised machine learning algorithm. Basically, it can cluster multiple things that are kind of together. For example, I give 500 images of cars, 500 images of people, 500 images of trees. If I run the correct machine algorithm, it will cluster into three groups. It won't know what it is, but it will cluster it into three groups. So I probably will be using classification because that makes more sense, but that is also, clustering is also an option. Then basically I will create the UI to actually do that. So before ending, I will show you. This is live data that is coming from my system right now. Yesterday I added this date changer. That is what I did for 1 hour yesterday at 11 p.m. You can go back into, you can select things. But now the tagging is not done yet. So that is the next step. Cool. Any doubts?